New brisket at Chipotle. Seasoned, smoked, seared, spiced, sauced, bold, and guaced. It's a whole new kind of brisket done the Chipotle way.
The preseason Mid-American Conference favorites are ready to hit the floor for the first time. It's the exhibition opener as the Buffalo Bulls host Division III's Medialle Mavericks. Hi, everybody, and finally, we're back in a real normal alumni arena. I'm Paul Peck with Matt Mattia. It feels great to have a normal college basketball experience, but the Bulls are hoping it's beyond normal. They're hoping it's just another normal trip to the NCAAs.
While they're coming in as the favorites, as you said, and that's not always easy, right? You've got the target on your back now. The rest of the conference is coming for you. Buffalo's going to be ready for it, and I'm super excited to get things started off tonight against Medialle.
It's their chance to kind of work out the kinks of the preseason. The opponent, a late addition. We'll talk more about that, but here are the Medialle Mavericks. Fuel for victory, brought to you by Intense Milk.
A lot of new faces with Medialle. You got to look to your seniors. Kendall McGill and Rodney Graves. They're two really good players. They're going to score a bunch and really be keys for Medialle. So look to your seniors. They'll help carry you through and really soak up the moment. Right as of about 48 hours ago, Medialle had no idea that they were even going to be playing this game, as Paul said. We'll talk about that in a little bit. So what an opportunity for these guys to come and play a team like Buffalo here in Alumni Arena.
The UB Alumni Association brings us our starting lineups, along with McGill and with Graves. Smith, Sanders, and LaTapia round out the starting five for the Medialle Mavericks. On the Buffalo side, lots of familiar names, which is why they're the favorite to win the MAC. Sagu, Jack is the one new name, Jonathan Williams, Josh Mbala, and Brock Bertram. Matt, how about the Bulls' fuel for victory?
Look, Paul, you got to shoot to get hot and shoot to stay hot. And what I mean by that is this is a great way for Buffalo to get hot and get their legs under themselves, because it is not going to be an easy task against the Wolverines come Wednesday for their season opener. So this is a great time to sort of get used to the flow of a basketball game and stay focused. Look, Medialle is going to be outmatched. They're a little bit smaller, a little less athletic. Buffalo has to stay focused and take advantage of this trial run.
Well, this game didn't happen till slightly over 24 hours ago, Matt. The Bulls were scheduled to play Damon in their exhibition opener, but a COVID issue at Damon meant they had a bag out of the game. But Damon head coach Mike McDonald, who coached Medialle head coach Keith Hack in college, called Keith up and said, hey, maybe give Jim Weitzel a call, and that's how we get this game happening tonight.
Well, really good on both of the coaches, right? Good on Jim Weitzel to say, look, yeah, absolutely, let's get this going, because quite frankly, they need to have a practice run before Michigan, and good for Medialle for kind of taking advantage of it, saying, what the heck, what do we have to lose? Let's go play the Bulls in Alumni Arena.
Absolutely. So the Medialle guys are excited for the reasons that Matt said. We know the Bulls are excited to get out there and run against somebody else and get the good vibes of this season off to the good start. The tap opening tap won by Brock Bertram. And here comes Buffalo's offense on display for the first time this season. Jonathan Williams right down the lane. Contact, loose ball, and a foul is going to go on Jorge LaTapia of Medialle.
Well, Jonathan Williams sporting not only the new jerseys that Buffalo's rocking, but a new haircut. Clean cut for Jonathan Williams, and nice drive here to get things started. I like that. Aggressive, attack the rim. Jonathan developed an outside shot last year, really, but is still at his best when he's going to the rim.
I had a chance to interview Jonathan a couple days ago. He said, nope. I said, you've had a different haircut all 4 years. He goes, nope, this is the one. I'm locked in. This is staying this way for the season.
So I'll believe it when I see it.
So there you go. In case you're wondering exactly what the hairstyles are going to be for the Bulls this year. One of two free throws for the senior from Rochester, New York, Jonathan Williams, and we are underway here with the Bulls getting the first points of the season. A little contact there, and that looked like a little arm hook, and that one is going to go on Medialle.
Yeah, I wasn't sure if they got the hook, like you said, or if that was a moving screen. I don't know which Maverick player they got, but same result.
Yep, I think it might have been the screen because it was Jorge LaTapia that got called for it. This is Ronaldo Rondo Sagu. Going to run the point this year for the Bulls. Hands off to Maceo Jack off back iron, no good. Brock Bertram with the board, and he gets fouled. So the one name that would be somewhat unfamiliar to Bulls fans, although not really unfamiliar in any kind of way, as you look at Keith Hack in his third season as the Medialle head coach, a former player at Medialle, an outstanding player at Medialle. And there's Josh Mbala up and in.
Yeah, to finish your thought about Maceo there, it's funny that, you know, Maceo Jack might be a new name if you're a strictly Buffalo basketball, men's basketball fan, which I can't imagine there's many of those exist anymore with how good the women have been. But son of course, head coach Felicia Leggett Jack, and quite the bloodline for Maceo there. His mom, of course, Coach Jack, one of the best players ever to play at your alma mater, Syracuse. In fact, her jersey's going to be retired there soon. His dad, David, played nationally volleyball for the Jamaican national team. So that's quite the bloodline to come from there.
Janathan Williams with the feed to Mbala, but the foul will come before the pass. As you watch Janathan head down the baseline, and Rodney Graves steps in and draws the foul. So yeah, and of course, Maceo Jack played his high school basketball here in Western York, just up the road at Williamsville North. So it's kind of a cool homecoming, but beyond that, he figures to be a real key part of what the Bulls want to do with shots like that. A little off on the three.
Yeah, it's a big get, really. We'll talk more about Maceo as the game progresses, but that's a huge get for Buffalo.
And up and off glass and in for Travis Sanders. Oh, hello about that.
Hello, Maceo. Come on with that.
Welcome home, Maceo Jack, with the Tomahawk Slam. He's supposed to be here for his three-point shooting, but if he can do some of that, it would be welcome.
Man, the women just finished their game, so I think Coach Jack might still be with the squad, but if I could have gotten a live look in on Coach Jack during that dunk, that would have been well worth the price of admission.
Jim Weitzel's in his third year as the Bulls head coach, 36-21, but his 26th overall season as a college basketball head coach. Nice drive to the hoop, up and in for Rodney Graves, the leading score, returning scorer for the Medialle Mavericks. Janathan Williams drains it. Oh, it's so good to see those fans clapping and happy to see an exciting show put on by their team. Stolen away by Williams. Sagu got his head up, looking left, looking right. Alley-oop, layup goal for Josh Mbala.
What do you do? What are you supposed to do right there if you're Medialle? I believe that was Bryce Smith who was left, and it was. Poor Bryce Smith left on an island. Do you step up and stop the ball of Rondo Sagu running downhill, or do you stay home and try, at least attempt, to defend Josh Mbala? It looked like he tried to stay home, and really it didn't work out too well.
If you're an NFL safety, are you getting right in the middle of Derrick Henry coming at you?
No, sir.
Of the field?
No,
sir. Maybe
sir-y.
That's the best equivalent we could give to you.
I'm telling you, he looks like him out there. When he's running downhill, do not get in his way.
Free throw to complete the three-point play for the senior from Bordeaux, France. It will not go, but Bertram grabs the board. Williams stumbles, gets it to Sagu for three. Bullseye.
New Nets, that's the second 73 that's gotten rung up on the rim like that. They are exercising the Nets here so far.
And Buffalo running and gunning out to an early lead here. And again, we all understand what this matchup is. It's a Division III program that, you know, is welcoming the opportunity to come in here. But, I think everybody who's a college basketball fan understands what likely is going to happen here today.
Yeah, you know what? And it's mutually beneficial, because if not for Medialle, then Buffalo's sitting at home tonight. There was a real possibility that there was going to be no game after Damon had the COVID protocols, which means Buffalo's going into Michigan ice cold. So really, this is great for Buffalo and for Medialle, as I said. What an opportunity to come into Alumni Arena. Bunch of people in the crowd, bright lights. Really, really mutually beneficial, I think, here, and really what college basketball is about.
Long on the three for Janathan Williams. Rebound pulled in by Graves. Graves steps into the lane and hits.
I'm impressed.
The senior from Woodbridge, Virginia, Rodney Graves. That will prompt a Buffalo timeout.
I'm impressed.
And, you know, and we had a chance to talk to Medialle head coach Keith Hack. And he said, I'm excited. This is a good experience. We don't get to play in a big arena. We got to get used to media timeouts. We're not used to those. He said, we're not used to somebody handing us a full water bottle. Normally, those we have to fill ourselves. So That is how Medialle is approaching this game.
And it really kind of puts it into perspective, even for you and I. It's not like you and I are out there playing, but I think we get spoiled with the amenities we have here and the high level of basketball we get to watch. And just to sort of hear Coach Hack talk about that, really, I mean, I'm sitting there smiling. My phone was on mute, but I'm like, that is pretty darn cool that he's like, how awesome for my guys to be able to do something that they're not going to be able to do, to come here and play a team like Buffalo who's got postseason aspirations and a real shot at making the tournament. And it's just it's a great game, and I'm thrilled that they were able to work it out.
Knocked away, quick hands by Medialle. Here's Kendall McGill. McGill's got it on the left side. Steps back. Feeds for the three-point attempt to Travis Sanders, and it's a four-point game.
Tell you what, you sort of get lost in translation when you hear Division III. These kids can play, and they can play good. Let me tell you, they are shooters. They're going to go all out from start to finish. Don't think that Medialle is going to let up anytime soon, albeit they're probably outmatched height and athleticism.
And a little sloppy by the Bulls, and Bala loses it, and the block shot by Maceo Jack. You think he's a little fired up to play his first basketball
yeah.
in just about a year?
I mean, think about all the baskets he's put up here in Alumni Arena, just not with a Buffalo uniform on, and I think this feels pretty darn good to be back home and doing stuff like that.
And he blocked it off the defender, and possession to the Bulls. Substitution for Buffalo, David Skogman, Trayvon Fagan in the ball game, and another turnover by Buffalo. That's three in a row right now. We know how turnovers bother Jim Weitzel. He isn't going to be happy right at the moment. Nearly another one right there. Sagu, and yet another turnover. That's the fourth in a row by Buffalo. We get our first media timeout. Get used to that, Mavericks. Take a break. We're early on here in Alumni Arena exhibition opener. Buffalo by four.
Football players need to be confident they're making the right decisions.
What's up with CeeDee Lamb?
By analyzing everything from player stats to expert opinions, Watson cuts through the noise to deliver game-changing insights.
Boomer Bust says CeeDee Lamb is good.
Someday you'll be better than your grandpa.
You try it.
I don't know what to draw.
It doesn't matter what, just a line. Throw yourself in. Take my place. Don't be frustrated.
Okay.
Show me what you got there. Wow. Absolutely beautiful.
It's excited and happy to be here at Alumni Arena, checking out a UB men's basketball game. We had a good crowd for the women's exhibition game earlier as well.
Good. There's people in the stands. I'm with it right now. This is the way to rock here. And, you know, and you and I last year just did a lot of looking at each other. Right, there was no one else in here. We had to create our own energy. And now look at this. Fans yeah. are back, baby. I love it.
And energy, and they've yes. liked what they've seen with some of the energy shown by the Bulls here. A little sloppy, though, as we mentioned.
Yeah, probably a good thing that that media timeout came when it did, or I don't think Coach Weitzel was going to let that go much further.
And there's a turnover forced by the Bulls into the hands of newcomer Curtis Jones. Nearly another turnover. Skogman having trouble with it. Finally gets rid of it. That's Mbala, and he has it knocked away and stolen. And then a foul call. And this has not been a good sequence for Buffalo. They seem to be trying too hard, Matt.
Maybe doing a little too much. Get back to basics a little bit. You know, do what Buffalo does best. That's defend and then, you know, get out and see what happens on the offensive end when you're running. But it's just maybe a little bit like, I don't know, lackadaisical isn't really the word. Just rust probably is what it is at the end of the day. I mean, these are some of the best players in the conference, and according to their peers, the best team in the conference. So it'll take them a second to get into the swing of things.
Five turnovers early for the Bulls. That's a key stat for Jim Weitzel. Something he's always looking for to keep his team limiting those. Three-pointer from the left corner, no good, by Tyler Seeley. And here comes Curtis Jones. Into the front court, the freshman from Minneapolis. Gonna drop it for the three from Josh Mbala. You mean to tell me he's adding that to his game this year?
He shot it a little bit last year. And I remember when you and I were calling a couple of those games, he shot 25% from three. I feel like a very just heat-of-the-moment three-point shooter. When he is feeling it and he's running up and down the court being point guard and Bala that we know he can, he's going to shoot some threes.
There may be a question of whether his foot was on the line or not on that three-pointer.
Yeah, it looked like this motion that they were going to look at it at the next stop.
And that was an out-of-bounds, speaking of feet on the line. Kind of not realizing it. That was Dante Moultrie turning it over for Medialle. Jones, Fagan, double team, triple team on Mbala. He'll try to break through it, fight the traffic, and draw the foul.
That's got to be, Josh Mbala has to be one of the better transfers, one of the better gets, not only for Buffalo, but in all of college. I mean, name me someone who has transferred from a team like Texas Tech, say, to Buffalo and has been more impactful than Josh Mbala. I mean, that is a heck of a transfer that he has been here to Western New York.
Yeah, and for those people that don't remember, he spent a year on that Texas Tech team that went to the national championship game,
yep.
Didn't play very much, wanted to play, and then comes here. So now he's headed towards his third year in Buffalo, preseason first team All-MAC in the poll and the voting that came out yesterday. And, you know, outstanding second team All-MAC a year ago, 15 points a game and just under 11 rebounds, and really one of the top rebounders in the entire country.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, and look at it. He's got the perfect frame for what Buffalo wants to get done. He's super mobile. He's really, really long, and he is wildly athletic.
6'7", 220, Josh Mbala. And again, he's always been a great rebounder. He's always been great within 5 feet of the basket, but we've seen through the years him expand his game to be able to do things like put up a three and hit it every once in a while.
Yep.
Mid-range jumpers, moves around the basket. It's been fun to watch him continue to develop over the years from a really raw but athletic and talented kid that first year to now a guy that doesn't have a lot of holes in his game.
Not many at all, and what a nightmare for a defense to prep for. I mean, typically at a guy his size and height, you're prepping for, all right, hey, how do we make sure he stays out of the paint? Let's keep him away. You can't keep him away from the rim because he'll kill you in the mid-range game now. I mean, it's incredible the development that we've seen out of Josh, and what a just a huge transfer for Buffalo and Coach Weitzel and his staff to have gotten.
Keyshawn Bruton to the free throw line for the Bulls. Hits the first. The senior from Spartanburg, South Carolina. The transfer from Coastal Carolina, who played 12 games last year for the Bulls after he became eligible, and a little under 6 points a game. I know they have a lot of high hopes for Keyshawn, and the transition year was hard on him last year, so a full year, full off season, ready to go here to become, play one of those key roles for the Bulls, which is just to get that three-point shooting more consistent and improved.
Exactly. Keyshawn is one of the guys I'm looking at this year to take a big stride and to really, really help shore up Buffalo on the offensive end. Shot at about 30% last year. If he can get that up a little bit, man, this just is a team that is absolutely loaded, especially now with Maceo coming in too.
Double-figure lead for the Bulls, their largest of the night at 10 points. Baseline drive, reverse layup attempt by Bile is no good. Bruton bangs and gets fouled, I believe.
Did they call a foul?
They call a foul, or was it out of bounds on Medialle? It's out of bounds off the fingers of Dante Wilcott. This is Trayvon Fagan. Feeds on the left side for Jonathan, who tried to sneak it inside to Skogman. Couldn't do it. It hit a leg. Thought about it there, Trevor Young did. He's a ways out at the top of the key. Oh, nice pass down low. That's going to be goaltending. That's going to count as a basket for Bile off the feed from Wilcott. Joe Rory Bile, junior from Oxon Hill, Maryland, gets credit for that one.
It's a great look. Just good basketball.
Yeah, you can, I think you can clearly see some talent on this Medialle
no,
team.
No question.
You know, I mean, again, the reality of the division difference between Division III is a little smaller, maybe a little slower, not quite as deep, and maybe just not that super crazy a level of talent that guys like Mbala and Williams and Sagu have, but that doesn't make any of these guys any less of a basketball player.
Not at all. They're well coached. Ton of skill on this team. I mean, just sitting and watching them in warm-ups, they are stroking it from beyond the arc. And look at this. I mean, that's a heck of a take from Bile. I mean, this team has a lot of talent. I'm very, very impressed.
Plus, they've been sort of had their pent-up energy because of COVID last year, they only played officially two games, bunch of exhibitions that gave them, I think, seven. But they really haven't played any form of basketball since in 2 years. A little bang on the table there in front of us for Keyshawn Bruton as he couldn't figure out how to pull that one in. So far early on, star of the night has been Maceo Jack. Back home and slamming it home.
Give a gift with her name on it. Personalize the holidays with one-of-a-kind gifts she'll remember. Thoughtfully designed by you for her. Give fewer, better, every day. Gliana.
Millions of fantasy football players need to be confident they're making the right decisions.
What's up with CeeDee Lamb?
By analyzing everything from player stats to expert opinions, Watson cuts through the noise to deliver game-changing insights.
Boomer Bust says CeeDee Lamb is good.
Well, Matt, you talked about why this game was important because that's not how the Bulls want to play their first game of the year on the road against the sixth-ranked Wolverines.
Yeah, Juwan Howard and the Michigan Wolverines are pretty darn good. So, yeah, I mean, there's a number of reasons you better be playing good basketball against Michigan. Being the first game of the year would have been tough. I mean, don't get me wrong. That is brutal to shake off the rust against the number six team in the country. So, really, as I said, this could have been a no game. So, I mean, this is all credit to Medialle. It was Coach Hack who reached out, as Paul said, to Coach Weitzel and said, let's have a game. And I can imagine that Coach Weitzel said, yes, please, because the last thing I need is my guys going in cold to take on the number six Michigan Wolverines in less than a week.
That game is next week. You'll be able to see it on the Big Ten Network. Very challenging non-conference schedule for the Bulls, partly because nobody really wanted to play them. I think you can understand why.
Why would you?
There's a three drained by Kendall McGill.
Well, there's the other one of the 1-2 punch I talked about in the open. Rodney Graves, we've seen. He's been great. Kendall McGill, though, he can really score. He had 30 points last year, 2 years ago, rather, on December 12th before COVID hit, so he can fill it up.
Sagu misses on the three. McGill steps in the lane and draws a foul.
Tell you what, there's a motor in these young guys right here. They are getting up and down the court early, and if you're Coach Hack, I think you're pretty darn happy with how the first, call it 9 minutes or so far, of this game has gone so far.
McGill's a senior from Largo, Maryland, as Matt alluded to. 25 starts, their number three scorer in their last full season of 2019-20. I looked at the roster and saw Kendall Gill, and I'm like, wait a minute, the former Illinois star and NBA, longtime NBA player, wasn't sure if there was a relation or not until I realized it was McGill, not Gill. But that's a name from the past for college basketball and NBA fans. Outstanding player.
We got ourselves a one-point ball game here,
yes,
people.
Yes, we do. And much credit to the Medialle Mavericks who have come in here ready to play. And kind of weathered that early storm of a couple of big slams and a couple of high-flying shots and plays by Buffalo, but right now it's the six turnovers by the Bulls that has sort of pulled them back a bit. That's the second foul on Rodney Graves of Medialle. And it sends Jonathan Williams, preseason first team All-Mac. Can't make that free throw. Mbala there for the rebound. He misses the putback, gets it again, and hits.
he just doesn't quit. It almost seems like his second and his third jump are higher than his first. I don't get it. He just got springs in those kicks. Oh, good D.
Takeaway by Bruton. Steps into the lane and hits.
Talk about motor.
Man. And that's, again, there's a little bit of the Division I athlete that can anticipate that pass and is fast enough to get there to break it up and make sure he finishes on the other end as Keyshawn Bruton did that time. Three-point play by Keyshawn Bruton. 5 points for him in this game. And again, that's another one of those unsung players that off the bench could really be a key guy this year for Jim Weitzel's squad. Up and under move attempted. Shot clock at 10, knocked away again. McGill trying to make something happen. Instead, the corner three from Sanders will not go.
How about Josh's ability to defend as well? I think that's sort of an unsung part of his game as well. The defensive player of the year in the conference, 34 steals out of a guy that's, you know, down low protecting the rim a lot. I mean, that's crazy good. He's just so well-rounded.
Career rebound average of over 10 for Josh Mbala. Had that incredible 20 rebound performance in the MAC tournament against Akron last year.
Tied the single game record for the conference tournament in 20 boards. He set the record. He had 50 rebounds in three games. I mean, that's just, you're playing a different game.
McGill trying to create a little space with Sagu. Can't hit the jumper. Skogman with the board. Stutter step move by Sagu. Dumps it off for Mbala in the lane. Falling, throws it up. But Jonathan's there to clean it up. ...7-0 run right now for the Bulls after Madai had cut this to a one-point game. Top of the key three will not go for Graves. Bruton's three will not go. Skogman quickly with the board. Back to Bruton, another three, no good. Graves with the board.
He was feeling it. I'm all right with it.
Crossover move into the lane. Sanders, no good. Tipped away into the hands of Sagu.
Oh, boy.
Sagu for Mbala. Up and under move.
Oh, you're kidding
me. In. What a basket by Josh Mbala.
Oh, stop that. What is this? Look at this. Sagu all the way up. Two guys there. Up and under. I don't think he saw the rim. You know that? That is just natural feel for where you are. And the body control to glide, flip it. Yeah, that's pretty darn good, huh?
That is pretty darn good. We've seen some amazing plays like that by Mbala in spurts throughout his career, but there just seems to be, even here tonight, a little more intensity coming from Josh. Like, maybe he's told himself he's got something he wants to prove this year. 13 points for Josh Mbala early in this one. And the Bulls have pulled out to their largest lead of the night. Cross-court pass. Three-pointer up and in. Jaquan Washington.
Foul there on Madai. Can't see the number. Kendall McGill, actually, they're going to get. He reached in on Sagu, trying to get a little something going there in the backcourt.
So that's two on McGill, three on Graves. Mm. They're two key scorers in this one for Madai, and it will send Rondo Sagu to the free throw line.
And Graves is still in the game, so that's something you don't often see. Usually with two fouls, you head to the bench, let alone three in the first half. But I think that's maybe a little bit of Coach Hack sensing that I can't really take my guys out this early if I want to keep it close.
13 points a game and over 4 assists per game last year for Rondo Sagu. Up that to a 19-point per game average in the MAC tournament. But the stat that jumped out the most for Rondo Sagu is 107 assists versus only 58 turnovers.
It's excellent taking care of the ball. Really, really good. And now he's just a senior. I mean, the fact that he's got another entire year here and what he did distributing and taking care of the ball, he's about as good of a point guard as you can ask for.
It's kind of amazing to think that Sagu and Jonathan Williams are seniors already. You know, they were freshmen on that outstanding top 25 team for the Bulls, led by Massenburg and Perkins, and didn't play a lot because of that. That thought occurred to me, like, man, I can't believe those guys have been here for 4 years already.
Well, you know, another thought, and I'm not sure they're going to take it because I'm sure both of those guys have pro aspirations, but because of COVID, there is a chance, if they so chose, to come back again next year, which
sure.
would just be crazy.
That's the third foul on Kendall McGill.
And what do you do here? You've got Graves on the bench. McGill's got three. Graves has three. Do you just trust your senior? And
does Mbala look a little thinner this year?
You know, I can't tell. The jerseys are cut a little bit different. I don't know if he's lost any weight or cut down a little bit, but he does look pretty fit, I will say.
Well, it doesn't seem to either be bothering him one way or the other based
no,
on what
no.
we've seen already
Ain't
here.
That the truth.
The pure fact that he could be more athletic than he has been is scary.
Didn't think that was possible.
Misses both free throws, though, and a rebound to Madai, and they're looking to run. Quickly, too hard off the glass for Dante Wilcott.
See you, Maceo, down there rebounding as well. He's got ups, too. Let's not forget about how athletic Maceo is. Known for his three-point shooting, of course, transferred in from Atlantic 10, George Washington. Very, very bright young man on the Dean's List down there at GW, political science major.
And it's got to feel good for him just to be home, right? This is home, as we mentioned, and so much familiarity around here for him. Rebounded by Bertram to Jack. Jonathan thought about it. He'll kick it to Maceo, three-pointer, good.
Love it. Absolutely love it. That's good basketball right there.
And I think, as you said, that's part of his main role here. He was a 40% three-point shooter in the limited time he played last year at George Washington. Second in the Atlantic 10 in three-pointers made the season before that. So that'd be one of those small little Achilles heels for the Bulls was their three-point shooting. Look at that crossover move by Jonathan Williams.
No doubt about it. If there was an Achilles heel to that team that scored over 80 points a game, it was the three-point shooting. And to bring in a guy like Maceo, whose IQ is off the charts and his ability matches that IQ, it's absolutely an opportunity that Buffalo got blessed with. That Maceo decided to come home to finish off his collegiate career here in Western New York.
Nice head and shoulder fake, but it won't fall for Jorge LaTapia. And I think Bruton and maybe even transfer Ty Perry are all some of those guys that will contribute to better three-point shooting for the Bulls. Sagu hits the layup, and the Bulls are on an 18-3 run here after Madai had cut it to 1 point, and they're starting to look like the team that's picked to win the Mid-American Conference. Back to Alumni Arena in a moment.
New brisket at Chipotle. Seasoned, smoked, seared, spiced, sauced, bold, and guaced. It's a whole new kind of brisket done the Chipotle way.
Millions of fantasy football players need to be confident they're making the right decisions.
What's up with CeeDee Lamb?
By analyzing everything from player stats to expert opinions, Watson cuts through the noise to deliver game-changing insights.
Boomer Bust says CeeDee Lamb is going.
I'm Paul Peck with Matt Mattia. And as we alluded to a little earlier, the preseason poll in the Mid-American Conference coming out yesterday, and beyond the fact that the Bulls are picked to win it, is that third line there.
Yeah, not only are they picked to win, but it seems to be the overwhelming thought in the conference and among the coaches that Buffalo is the best team in the conference. Yeah, Ohio ended up winning the MAC last year, went on to beat Virginia. They were sort of one of the early darlings of the March Madness tournament, but a huge loss when Jason Preston moved on. So I think Ohio's going to be very good as well, but right now it's tough to look at this Buffalo team from top to bottom and say otherwise that they're not the best team to beat here.
Maceo Jack can't hit the three. Skying in for the board is Jonathan Williams. They also do a poll in the MAC of which team is predicted to win the MAC tournament, which can be different than the one predicted to win the regular season, but not in this case. It was the Bulls in both.
Different in the women's case. The women's team was picked third to finish in the MAC, but they were picked to win the MAC tournament. They had five first-place votes, so like you said, it's can sometimes be a little different, but not on this side of things. Looks to be nearly unanimous.
Toledo, the other team that got that one first-place vote to win the MAC regular season that Buffalo did not get. That's a corner three. It is drained by Tyler Seely. That at least puts a little capper on the 20-3 Buffalo run after Medialle had pulled it within 1 point. Maybe someone mentioned something on the bench about it's a one-point game and
yeah,
the Bulls have responded.
Hello, wake up.
Or maybe they didn't have to mention it, and that might be the best sign of them all. Maceo Jack going to get called for the charge.
I'd like to see that. We don't have a great angle over here.
That's close.
Yeah, you know, he definitely initiated the contact, but it's way off to the left. I mean, look at this. It barely touches his shoulder. I don't know.
That's Jarori Bile that draws the foul there on Jack.
I'm projecting. I'm a known not a huge fan of the charge call in college basketball, or at least how often it's called, I should say.
Miss on the three by Seely. Jack quickly into the front court, kicks it for Jonathan. He's a three-point shooter as well. And that's what makes Jonathan Williams so tough. He might be the best slasher in the Mid-American Conference, but if you're going to play him for that, he can pop out and hit a three.
That was a cool shot. I don't know if Jonathan and Coach Hack know each other or something, but he just said something to Coach, and they both had the biggest smiles on their faces when Jonathan was backpedaling down. That was pretty cool.
Even if they don't know each other, I would suspect that would be Coach Jack going, that's not fair. You can't do that. Like, we're playing you because you're great around the basket. You can't pop out and hit 22-foot three-pointers.
That was funny. Coach had the biggest smile, and so did Jonathan. They were both laughing it up going down the court there. Coach just standing still, and Jonathan was backpedaling.
It's going to be Brock Bertram to the free throw line. Brock back for his sixth season. 23 years old, and they kind of kid Brock about being the old man here. Let's see if you can see it.
Let's watch this here. I don't know if Jonathan said something there, and you see the big smile on Coach's face. Jonathan's laughing it up going down the court. I don't know what. Maybe it's something earlier they said something, and then that was a I got you back type of thing, but
that's
that
awesome.
Was funny.
Good catch there, Matt. Good job. That's a pretty cool little moment there. So the elder statesman, Brock Bertram, makes a couple of free throws. Technically, he's not the oldest player on the Bulls roster, but...
Which is almost crazy to say out loud.
Yeah. There's the block for Brock. Brock block.
I think Jamon Bivens has that
title,
correct?
That is correct. I think Jamon is 24.
Yep.
Brock is 23. And again, that's the product of college athletics now.
Sure.
With the extra year, with COVID, you're going to get a lot of 22, 23, even 24-year-old guys in their fifth, sixth years. There might be a few occasions where you're going to get guys in their seventh years of college athletics, which is amazing.
What a weird time. Love it, though. Glad that Jamon's back. That's a good veteran voice to have.
And that's going to be a foul on Keyshawn Bruton. And again, hey, you know, the opportunity to keep playing a sport that you love.
Nobody
should be in any hurry to not be playing a game that you love anymore.
Are you kidding me? I didn't have to be playing anything. I wish I could have stayed a few extra years. Come on now. Wish I could have taken a medical year to go back for another year or two. That would have been fun.
You keep staying in college, you might call you a medical doctor. That's generally what happens when you stay in college that long.
Not me.
Foul was called on Skogman, and it will send to the free throw line Bile, Jarori Bile.
That is not crowd noise that we're pumping in, by the way. That just got really loud in here. There is a huge contingent of fans in the baseline section of fans here to our left. There is a lot of students that have turned out today.
Yeah, great turnout by the students. They've been had some pent-up excitement wanting to get out here and see their Bulls play.
Well, I said it in my call of the women's game before this. It's a two-way street. We miss having the fans here. We've said it. The players miss it, and you and I miss it. But the fans miss being here, too. I mean, this is big for the fans to be able to come back out as well.
Just look at the quickness on Mbala there. The ability to take that little drop step and blow by a defender is what makes him so dangerous around the basket. Long three off the rim. And no good for Washington.
Oh, good find.
Kick it out. Three is no good for Curtis Jones. Skogman puts it up and in. First two of the game for the sophomore from Wisconsin, David Skogman. Another one of those players figures to have a much bigger role this year, battling for a starting spot. We'll talk a little more about him later on. We take a timeout. Buffalo starting to pull away here, tail end of the first half.
New brisket at Chipotle. Seasoned, smoked, seared, spiced, sauced, bold, and guaced. It's a whole new kind of brisket done the Chipotle way.
Millions of fantasy football players need to be confident they're making the right decisions.
What's up with CeeDee Lamb?
By analyzing everything from player stats to expert opinions, Watson cuts through the noise to deliver game-changing insights.
Boomer Bust says CeeDee Lamb is going.
Well, for all the reasons that we talked about, this is a very good Buffalo team, including a couple of players that were named to the preseason first team All-MAC. No surprises with either of those guys.
No, definitely not. They've done everything that you need to do to earn that right. They're going to be absolute problems for the rest of the conference, for the rest of this year. Well-deserved to be on that first team, and really they're 1A and 1B of guys that need to have great years and will have great years when Buffalo wants to win a MAC championship.
Beyond that, Jim Weitzel, when asked to sort of assess his team, said he feels like the strengths of this team are rebounding. They've been one of the best teams rebounding in the country the last couple of years. They defend the three-point very well, and they're very good at the assist-to-turnover ratio. What he wants to see them do better is better overall field goal percentage defense, better individual defense, and to build on that assist-to-turnover to make it even a more important mark, and that comes from quality possessions and better shots.
Oh, there's
and
no
moving
doubt about
the ball, right?
Yep.
Jim has always taught me over the years that the most indicative stat of whether the Bulls are playing well or not is the assist number, because it means they're moving the ball, they're being unselfish, and that all means getting better shots like that one from Keyshawn Bruton.
Yeah, that's a guy who's been around for a long, long time, Coach Weitzel, who knows what he's doing. He's got over 400 wins, 24 years of that, Coach. He knows what it takes, so when he talks and says something, you listen. And that's absolutely right, Paul, that the assist number is the go-to number to see how well Buffalo's playing.
So right now it's 13 assists versus 7 turnovers. It was 6-6 at one point earlier in the first half. Even 13-7, you kind of want to be double, right? Isn't that generally the rule of thumb? And you're almost there.
A lot of teams don't ever get there. So if you can hang at about a 2.0 assist-to-turnover ratio, if you will, then you got nothing to complain about.
Trevor Young with the three. Buffalo, New York native. Frederick Law Olmsted High School hits the three. Whole host of Western New York natives on the Medialle roster, as you might imagine.
Yeah, but also, how about four international players as we get an over-the-back call, I believe.
Yep.
Yeah, but to sort of go along with the hometown players, two guys from England here on Medai, Klutz and Seeley. LaTapia's from Spain and Walters from Germany. I mean, that's unbelievable.
Now, there's a little bit of Skogman being 6'10" with a guy in front of him that he goes over the back on who's 6 foot. It's going to look like over the back when maybe it really wasn't, but Skogman gets called for it, and that will send Dante Moultrie, another one of those Western New Yorkers, Buffalo native, played North Tonawanda High School. He goes to the line, misses the first, and into the ballgame for his first official UB rebound is freshman Kuel Matting, the big guy wearing zero.
Ty Perry also checking in, another Atlantic 10 transfer here for the Buffalo Bulls, as Ty Perry comes to us by way of Fordham in the Bronx.
Native of Boston is Ty Perry, and you get a look at Curtis Jones, another one of those newcomers.
Yeah.
Transfer from Indian Hills Community College, which is the same community college that sent Dante Carruthers to Buffalo. And if Curtis Jones has an ounce of the intensity of Dante Carruthers, we're going to love him.
Yeah, you're talking about one of the best defenders this conference has ever seen. Dante Carruthers just did not know how to turn it down. I'm either playing basketball or I'm not. There was one speed for Dante. He was full bore ahead or he's hanging out not playing ball. I love, really miss watching Dante play.
Free throws are good for Curtis Jones. And that's Ty Perry on the defensive matchup right now. And that's a nice little pass and spin towards the basket. And the bucket up and in for Oscar Wolter. One of those international players from Munich, Germany. And there's Matting, and it's not going to count.
Matting nearly just took the rim off the backboard there. But kind of a cool story with Oscar Wolter. You know, we asked Coach Hack, how does it that there's four international players who find their way to Medialle in Western New York? And really, Coach said, Oscar reached out to him. They could only talk via Zoom because of COVID. Coach watched a couple of clips on a recruiting website. They got Oscar to sort of take a chance on them because, quite frankly, Oscar said, look, I've never been to Western New York. I've never been to Medialle, Buffalo, whatever. And Coach Hack must have had a good enough conversation with him to get him all the way from Munich. And here he is, playing ball in Alumni Arena.
Hey, the internationalization of basketball is obvious at all levels, and there's a lot of kids that are playing over in Europe that want the opportunity to come to play because they don't have college athletics over there.
Yep.
You know, and a kid like Wolter wants to be able to get a college education and continue to play sports because it's more of a club system in places like that. Here comes Jones, and he gets bumped on his way to the basket. So there's a lot of opportunities, and the smart kids like Wolter say, give me that opportunity. I am 100% willing to come to Buffalo, whether I know anything about it or not. I want to come because I want to play, and I want to get a good education.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it, and that's good on him for being the one to initiate and reach out. And Medialle, great school, so it's just pretty cool to see, you know, four international players make their way over the pond here and end up in Western New York here at a small school like Medialle.
Curtis Jones hits that first free throw. Curtis Jones comes from Minneapolis, Minnesota, a graduate of Cretton-Durham Hall High School, which among the other players whose names you would know that have come out of that high school, Joe Mauer, Paul Molitor, Chris Wanky, and Steve Walsh. How about that for a list of alumni to have attended Cretton-Durham Hall High School in Minneapolis?
Joe Mauer was my guy growing up watching Twins baseball and rooting for Joe.
Oh, look at the block by Matting, the 6'9" freshman. Stuffed that back at Oscar Wolter. Wolter might want to go back overseas after that one.
6'9", and I think his wingspan's about 13 feet long after watching that one. That was incredible length out of Matting. You can't teach length, that's what they say.
Nope. And he's a bit of a raw player, but 6'9", 200 pounds, put a little weight and strength on him. He's going to be a beast in the Mid-American Conference as time goes by. Under a minute to go here in the first half.
Go up. Oh, that was a heck of a pass.
Shot clock violation. Back on the other end, Ty Perry lays it in.
Life comes at you fast when you're playing Buffalo because that went from a heck of a pass down low to an almost bucket to blink your eye. 2 points going the other way.
First two in a Bulls uniform for Ty Perry.
You know, just to mention one more thing about the three-point shooting, we talked about Perry's another one that could help. He was number one on the Fordham Rams team last year in three-pointers made, so another option for UB from beyond the arc.
And it's very interesting how selective the recruiting was to try to fill a notch there. Time running out, and Perry is going to draw the foul with 1.4 seconds to go. He wanted that basket to wrap up the first half.
He was pretty juiced in warm-ups. I was kind of looking around, making sure I familiarized myself with all the new faces, and he looked about as excited as anybody in this arena to be out here playing basketball in a Buffalo uniform.
11 games last year at Fordham, as you mentioned. 37% three-point shooting there.
So that's two players
and
from the Atlantic 10
now. I'll say the interesting thing is he and Maceo Jack probably matched up a lot over the years.
Definitely.
So here's your final second of the first half, and there will be no shot. And for a while there, it was a little sloppy for Buffalo. It was a one-point game at 19-18, but the Bulls have started to pull away, and it's a 31-point halftime lead. Matt and I return for halftime at Alumni Arena, coming up in a moment.
New brisket at Chipotle. Seasoned, smoked, seared, spiced, sauced, bold, and guaced. It's a whole new kind of brisket done the Chipotle way.
What is it?
So you can get to know your new granddaughter.
We're so glad you're here.
Oh, honey.
She just needs some time.
That was cool. You ought to be very proud. I'm proud of you. Here's another picture of your mommy. She smiles so hard her front tooth popped out.
Good night, Grandma. Did you call me grandma?
Into the Bulls exhibition opener. Now joined by Director of Communications, Brian Wolf. And Wolfie, we always like to catch up with you, get your thoughts on the season. But before we do that, we've had a chance to do some interviews getting ready for the season with guys like Jonathan Williams and Rondo Segoo. They are so much better interviewees as they've developed and gone through 4 years. That's a little bit of your job on the coaching department, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, these guys have been playing basketball their entire lives. So that comes easy to them. That's second nature. But what they don't get to do a whole lot in high school is the interviewing process. And people sometimes forget these guys come in as 18-year-old kids. They leave as 21, 22-year-old men. There's a lot of growing up going on there. So we try and coach them. We do mock interviews. We go back and we show them some of the interviews they've done. We try and prep them before interviews so they're not surprised by any questions. And it's just really nice to see that these individuals growing up as men, and just they're just get a lot more comfortable in front of the camera. And look, when you're going to the next level, whether that's the NBA, international, or going out into the private sector, it's kind of like a job interview. These guys get Googled, and there's a ton of content out there, and we want them to look good.
Thoughts on the season, expectations on this season for the Bulls?
Expectations are really high. I mean, a real veteran squad, a lot of guys back from last year. You lost Javon Graves, but this is a team that can be really special. And I know everyone saw the 18-19 season. And, you know, if this team plays to their potential, there's no reason that they can't duplicate something like that.
Appreciate the time, Wolfie. Thanks. Enjoy the season.
All right. Thanks, Paul.
Much more coming up. Halftime here at Alumni Arena, the Bulls in the exhibition opener. More from Alumni Arena coming up right after this.
History says, find jewelry for occasions. We say, forget occasions. Find jewelry for every day, minus the traditional markups. We're Mejuri, handcrafted like the olden days. Designed for the golden days ahead.
Millions of fantasy football players need to be confident they're making the right decisions.
What's up with CeeDee Lamb?
By analyzing everything from player stats to expert opinions, Watson cuts through the noise to deliver game-changing insights.
Boomer Bust says CeeDee Lamb is good.
Well, the Bulls looking every bit like the Mid-American Conference favorite here at halftime of their exhibition opener against Division III's Medialle Mavericks with a 61-30 lead. Now, again, it doesn't all happen here on the court at Alumni Arena, Matt. It happens with a lot of hard work over the summer.
Huge.
And the tradition has continued for the Bulls. Every year they head down to Ellicottville. No skiing or sitting by the fireplace drinking warm drinks. They go down there to bond and to learn. It's a fun experience for those guys, I think.
Yeah, I love it. Are you kidding me? I love Ellicottville. I'm sure they do too. It's a good spot to go, and really, you said it. I mean, a lot of it happens here in the gym, but I mean, almost as important as being able to play and being able to gel is liking each other, getting along with each other, having that chemistry. All championship teams do, so it's a pretty cool experience for these guys to be able to do that and kind of bond a little bit and you know, feel a little more comfortable and prep for the year.
So let's tag along on the Bulls basketball trip to the Southern Tier.
At the University at Buffalo, it starts with people. People full of passion, tenacity, and purpose. In a place where talent comes together, where ambition inspires action, and our differences make us stronger. Here's where big ideas are born. Success is celebrated. Lives are transformed. In Buffalo, we're excited for a challenge and confident that our best is yet to come.
Action is back at UB Stadium on Wednesday, November 17th as the Bulls host the Northern Illinois Huskies. Kickoff is at 7 p.m. There's more time like the present to get your tickets. To order, call 1-877-UB-THERE or visit ubbulls.com.
New brisket at Chipotle. Seasoned, smoked, seared, spiced, sauced, bold, and guaced. It's a whole new kind of brisket done the Chipotle way.
Whoa.
Every week, millions of fantasy football players need to be confident they're making the right decisions.
What's up with CeeDee Lamb?
How does ESPN help them make smarter trades and set the right lineup?
Does this look bad?
I don't know. I'm not that kind of doctor.
IBM Watson. By analyzing everything from player stats to expert opinions, Watson cuts through the noise to deliver game-changing insights.
Boomer Bust says CeeDee Lamb is going
to
boom.
To keep ESPN at the top of the fantasy sports world.
He's good.
What can Watson do for your business?
Start of the second half here at UB's Alumni Arena. When you need emergency treatment, a hospital's waiting room is the last place you want to be. Millard Fillmore Suburban Hospital offers online registration and video visits for non-life-threatening conditions. Visit kaleidahealth.org/video visits. Well, again, we talked about it. It was a little bit rough early on, as you might expect, the first competitive basketball game in an awful long time for both of these teams, and it took a little while for the Bulls to start to show who they are.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, like anything, you don't just come right out and jump right into exactly where you want to be. I mean, that's the point of these games. You and I have been saying it over and over again. That's why these games are played, because this is the time to do it. If you're going to turn it over six times in eight possessions or whatever the heck it was, now's the time to do it. But then they've sort of settled into this type of stuff.
Yeah, no shortage of highlights to show you. Despite that, Miss Maceo Jack's welcome home slam and Josh Mbala putting on a show. That might be what,
ridiculous.
Unfortunately, this game quote unquote doesn't count, but that might count as one of the five best plays of the year for the Bulls.
Oh, it literally has to. I mean, there's no way that's not on the Mount Rushmore of plays. I mean, that's a Sports Center top 10 play type of action there, and really what we've grown accustomed for. He has the ball in his hands. Get the cameras out, get the popcorn out, because Josh Mbala is going to do something crazy.
Yep, 15 points for Mbala, 13 points for Jonathan Williams, 10 points for Keyshawn Bruton. It's been more time for the guys beyond those big-name starters, as Jim Weitzel wants to get more people into the ball game,
yep,
and more people familiar with their roles. So I kind of expect we'll see a good more of that in the second half, maybe a little early on here for the starters, and then get some of those younger guys and the bench guys in there to see some playing time. On the Medialle side, you know, they started off great, shot the ball well, but then their two big scorers got foul trouble, both Graves and McGill with three, and that limited their time on the court, and now it was sort of a bunch of younger newcomer guys that have had a chance to play, and they haven't quite been as efficient as those veteran guys are. And, you know, again, we talked about turnovers, 9 in the first half for Medialle. They're shooting just 32%. Buffalo's shooting 53%. And Buffalo out-rebounding Medialle 32-14. None of that unexpected.
No. I mean, you're talking about one of the best teams in the country. I think they led the NCAA in back-to-back years, Buffalo has. In total rebounds, in rebounds per game. So, you know, that was to be expected. But really, I've been impressed overall with Medialle. I mean, you've come into a big arena on absolutely no notice with no chance to scout or prep or anything, and you just scored 30 points against a really, really good Buffalo team in the first half. This is a Medialle team. So far, they should be pretty darn proud of what they've done, and I think could win a bunch of games this year in the Allegheny Mountain Collegiate Conference.
Yeah, remember, as we talked about, this game didn't happen until yesterday morning after the original opponent, Damon, had to back out of the game because of COVID issues.
Yeah.
So this has all been a 24-plus, 36-hour event to make all this happen, and it's been good for Buffalo, and I think it's been good for Medialle as well, too. You got the starters in right now for the Bulls. That was Mbala trying to feed Brock Bertram, who draws the foul.
An exciting time, really, for Medialle. You've got a great young coach in Keith Hack, a guy who was an excellent player here at Medialle, as you said earlier. I mean, he's top 10 in 14 of their different categories all time, and they're moving to the Empire 8 next year out of the Allegheny Mountain Collegiate Conference, which is a big step up for a Division III conference. Better competition. It's better for travel. They're not spending so much time in Western Pennsylvania. They're going to be more and more here in New York, so I think Keith Hack's got a lot to be excited about moving forward with this Medialle squad and really the program as a whole.
Yeah, Empire 8 will be more schools like Alfred University,
yeah,
Nazareth, St. John Fisher, and Rochester. Much more regional rivalries as opposed to the heavier Western Pennsylvania opponents that they play now. So,
yeah, if you tell a program they only have to go up and down the thruway to Rochester a few times a year as opposed to driving 5 hours into Pennsylvania, I think you take that.
So we'll see what the Mavericks can do here in the second half, playing a lot of players. They have 19 players on their roster, so you know, at Division III, there's not the limitations. It's you want to play, come play if you're good enough to play.
Yeah, and these kids are good enough to play, trust me.
Long three by Smith is no good. Sagu, Maceo Jack down low for Bertram. Nice pass to Mbala. And Josh with that great first step, almost an unstoppable first step, as Mbala up to 17 points now.
He just plays so well through contact. He really almost looks for the contact when he's in the paint. He wants to initiate a little bit of contact, get his feet under himself, and so tough to guard.
And that three drained by Travis Sanders. Leading scorer right now for the Medialle Mavericks. Williams into the lane, able to avoid the charge, and grabs the basket.
That's a flopping warning, I believe.
Yep, it is. That's 15 now for Jonathan. When asked what he wants to improve in his game this year, he said better defense, better rebounding. Those are the things I'm working on. Again, he averaged, he averaged 17.5 points a game last year. But I'm sure he only hears that a few times from his Jim Weitzel about playing better defense. Huh?
Well, that college coaches. I mean, you never hear the end of it playing defense. There's very few coaches in America that aren't stressing defense first. Oh, boy. Can't leave him open.
Maceo Jack can't hit the open three. Jonathan Williams will cross over 1,000 career points at some point early on in this season. 9:24 going in.
Well, I like that he brought up the rebounding, because with Jonathan's athleticism and his build, he's a double-double. I mean, he should be he averaged just under 7 rebounds a game last year. But, I mean, the way he plays the game, he should be a walking double-double.
And that's a foul out for Kendall McGill, one of the top scorers from Medialle, and it's been a tough evening for him as he leaves with just 5 points.
And Coach Hack's not happy about this, and he's going to get his money's worth over here as the referee shows him to where he should be standing on the sideline. And I don't blame him. I don't think you're asking the referees, why are you falling out my best player 70 feet away from the basket on a little cheesy little hip check, you know? So Coach Hack didn't really appreciate that call so much, and I don't blame him. He's still yelling. Good for you.
Yeah, you got to get your money's worth, man, you know?
Good for you.
Get to watch all those other guys who get to yell at the officials all day from that spot here in this arena. It reminds me of an old famous Marv Levy line, which was, he used to tell his players, act like you've been there before, until the third string tight end caught a touchdown pass and went nuts and drew a celebration foul. And he told Marv, I'm never going to be there ever again before. I haven't been there before, I'm never going to be there again.
Oh, this is showtime here.
It is.
Ooh, okay.
Just a little lay-in there with the kiss off the glass for Josh Mbala.
He's shown his whole repertoire. He's got the touch. He's got the finesse.
Long three by Bryce Smith falls. First points of the game for the sophomore from College Station, Texas. Look at the body control by Jonathan Williams.
He's a freak in all the best ways. He is just a freak athlete. He is different.
19 points for Jonathan, 19 points for Mbala. Smith's feeling it.
Oh,
he sure is.
Quick trigger. Hello.
He's a shooter, and he's showing it. 2 threes in a row for Bryce Smith.
Let's get a heat check next time for Bryce. Let's go. Get him the ball. Feed him.
'95 wins for the Bulls over the last 4 seasons. More, that's top 15 in the country. It's tops in the MAC. Just an example of how good this program has been. What a no-look pass by Maceo, but Brock Bertram can't finish. And Bertram will grab another rebound and feed his teammate Sagu. Breaks the double team to Williams. Williams hangs, feeds it back to Sagu. 3. No good. Tip up and in. Trayvon Fagan. The Bulls are running. They like running, don't they?
Well, it was funny because when we talked to Coach Hack, he said, well, you know, we like to run. You know, he played under Coach McDonald, who was a Damon, as you pointed out.
Flop warning called there.
And Coach McDonald, a similar type of player. You know, they like to go fast, but I don't think it was going to work out too well against Buffalo, and so far it hasn't.
Second half of the exhibition opener for the Buffalo Bulls. We come back to Alumni Arena as you watch the Trayvon Fagan put back. We're back in a moment.
New brisket at Chipotle. Seasoned, smoked, seared, spiced, sauced, bold, and guaced. It's a whole new kind of brisket done the Chipotle way.
Beautiful.
Wanna dance with me?
Yeah. Oh, here's another picture of your mommy. This love, this
love, this love. Well, the schedule's gonna get a lot tougher after this one for the Bulls. We already touched on the fact that they head to Michigan, take on the sixth-ranked Wolverines in Ann Arbor. But then even after that, North Texas is a tough game on the road. Yep. Then they go down to Cancun, a couple of good games down there, and then that St. Bonaventure game against the 24th-ranked.
23rd.
Bonnie's 23rd-ranked. Sorry about that.
Can't sneak that one past me, Paul. Come on.
No, I know. So there are some tough games. And then a game against Canisius down at the arena coming up. So it's a challenging non-conference schedule, which Jim Weitzel says, bring it on. I want
Love
it.
That.
I want to challenge my team. You know, he remembers being a part as an assistant coach of that team in 18, where they went to West Virginia and won, went to Syracuse and won. You know, can this team win some of those games like at Michigan? We'll see. But they were great tests that prepared the Bulls for Mid-American Conference play. That's a turnover and a steal. And ahead of the field for the easy layup is Travis Sanders.
You know who asks for good out-of-conference schedules and who says bring it on? Coaches who have good teams. That is exactly what's happening here. You know you've got a good team. You're confident. Hello, David Skogman. And I think we just got a warning possibly between, I would say by that assessment, Bruton and Sanders, I think, by first glance.
You saw a little bit of contact there as the ball went in the basket. There's
double warning, I believe, was issued. But, you know, Coach Weitzel's confident in his team, and he should be, and that's exactly what you got to go do. And the tough part about a school like Buffalo, and you kind of said this earlier, is a lot of the really good teams, like the top 10 teams, don't want anything to do with them because there's a good chance they know they might lose.
Yeah, and honestly, you know, even the Power 5, mid-level Power 5s are really good. Mid-majors don't necessarily want to come here either because they know how good the Bulls are.
That is a tough, tough ask to come here and win in Alumni Arena.
That's a heck of a step-back three for Rodney Graves, Player of the Year candidate in the AMCC.
Yeah, Graves has a chance to go play elsewhere after his career here in Medialle, too. And Coach Hack said he's super excited about the Rodney Graves future. That's a coach who's got his priorities figured out.
Well, four shots at the basket for the Bulls. Fagan couldn't get it in. So, you know, again, you saw in that graphic, the Bulls are going to welcome in an NAIA school from Pittsburgh, Point Park University, just to get some games.
Yes.
Just to get some games.
Got St. John Fisher on the schedule on.
And you know, and the other consideration is because, you know, the Bulls are conscious of who they play and their net rankings, they're not just going to play any mediocre to poor, you know, upstate New York kind of a team, because that doesn't help them. If they want to be in a position after a good season to maybe contend for an at-large bid, you have got to have that good net ranking. And that only comes by playing other good teams, of which you generally have to go on the road to do it.
No Niagara on the schedule this year.
Yeah, which, you know, a lot of that has been messed up because of last year, too. So. I think the Bulls will play at Bonaventure for 2 years in a row, which is an oddity, and then I think Bona comes up here 2 years in a row.
Trying to even it back out. Right. There's a lot of balancing that's going to have to done you know, over the next couple of years here in athletics.
It's a comfortable 30-point lead for the Bulls. We'll take a timeout from here at UB's Alumni Arena.
Time is the new luxury. When everything works together, smarter, better. I have the freedom to be who I want to be. Intuitive dressing designed with me in mind. Elegant ease that fits every moment. A quality of detail that reflects my values. living fewer, better, every day. Kuyana.
Every week, millions of fantasy football players need to be confident they're making the right decision.
What's up with CeeDee Lamb?
How does ESPN help them make smarter trades and set the right lineup?
Does this look bad?
I don't know. I'm not that kind of doctor.
IBM Watson. By analyzing everything from player stats to expert opinions, Watson cuts through the noise to deliver game-changing insights.
Boomer Bust says CeeDee Lamb is going
to
boom.
To keep ESPN at the top of the fantasy sports world.
He's good.
What can Watson do for your business?
Words to live by. More cowbell.
Always. The only problem with this, we Always. Need more cowbell.
I got a fever. The only prescription is more cowbell. Hey, at roughly about the 12-minute mark of the first half, the Bulls had six turnovers. They had four in a row. We were talking about it then. Well, guess what? Only three since then. Yep. As the turnovers remain at nine for Buffalo versus 19 assists, well beyond that 2-to-1 ratio, or slightly beyond the 2-to-1 ratio, which will make Jim Weitzel happy. Skogman misses on the three.
Had him. Had a nice little opportunity for a pick and roll there.
Get it to the high post there for Carmichael. And a baseline drive is blocked. Blocked by Curtis Jones. Fagan for three. Not normally a three-point shooter. Look at the long rebound with the long arms by Skogman. Can't finish. And a break for Madai. Into the lane. Hanging. Can't hit. Was Dante Wilcott. Bruton was hot in the first half, not there. Skogman cleaning up on the boards. Skogman's a really interesting player, Matt. We've seen glimpses of him. 16 points and 11 rebounds and a double-double against Miami last year. 6'10", 225, can shoot, can run the floor. We said he's battling for a starting position on the team this year. If he can emerge a little bit and be one of those tall, long three-point shooters that we see all over the MAC, that would be a nice addition for the Bulls. Timeout from Alumni Arena, back after this.
New brisket at Chipotle. Seasoned, smoked, seared, spiced, sauced, bold, and guaced. It's a whole new kind of brisket done the Chipotle way.
Here we go.
Nope.
That's for the box.
Yeah, but first we have to turn this one on, huh?
Don't you need the other one? Found this one. Fan.
Blinds. Oh, it's on.
Tomo. Now, which one finds our show?
No idea. AC, garage.
At Spectrum, we think finding your shows should be easy.
Jacuzzi.
So the Spectrum Guide puts all your favorite streaming apps in one place.
Ready.
The UB women's team had a successful exhibition opener earlier tonight against Damon. Their regular season opener comes up on Tuesday night. You'll see it here on ESPN+. Canisius comes into Alumni Arena. You're in charge that night. I'll be in Oxford, Ohio for football maction on Tuesday night, so you're in charge.
I'm taking over. You don't have to tell me twice. That's going to be a fun game. Canisius having a little bit of a down couple of years. Buffalo not so much. Bulls definitely the favorite in that one, especially after what we saw earlier this evening from Coach Jack and her Bulls. They looked primed and ready to go, much like what we're seeing here tonight with the guys.
Yeah, new coaching staff for Canisius, so that'll be part of the storyline of that one. But a good chance to officially open the season for the UB women's team, who looked very impressive here tonight, especially the return of Summer Hemphill.
Yeah.
Outstanding.
We'll talk about a tough schedule, too, quick about the women as we get a quick trigger three.
That's Cottrell Blocker, freshman for the Bulls, nailing the three-pointer. Freshman out of Rochester. Got players from Rochester just keep popping up on these rosters around here.
Give them to me. Think about it on both sides. Give me more. Janathan and Dante and
DeAsia,
Sierra. Like, come on. But, yeah, the women's team, we get to go down to the Bahamas, which isn't so bad of a trip.
Oh, yeah.
But you got South Carolina first. Then you play, if we win or lose that, you play the winner or the loser of Oregon, Oklahoma, UConn, Syracuse, South Florida are all in that tournament.
Rewind that sentence. You get to go to the Bahamas.
Yeah.
You can stop there. The Atlantis Resort is where the Bulls women's team will play. Same place the Bulls won the Bahamas Bowl, where they stayed a couple years ago. One of the coolest, most fun places in the world is the Atlantis Resort.
Just the most mediocre tan out. I'm going to be so mediocrely tanned with my Irish skin. It's going to be awesome.
I'm telling you, hit those water slides.
I'm in.
More time on the water slides, less in the casino. Trust me, that's my advice to you.
God, it almost sounds like you know me.
Ty Perry to the free throw line here for the Bulls. Rolls in that one. 5 points for him. The Bulls bring back 11 returning players, including 9 seniors on this veteran-laden roster. 6 new players, of which Ty Perry is one of them. We showed you saw Cottrell Blocker before.
It's a good blend of guys so far, from what I can tell. It's a nice mix of skill sets.
Well, I think when you're in a position where you bring in some talented freshmen or newcomers, and you really don't need them to come in right away and be key players for you, that's how you want to build your program. It goes back to when Jonathan Williams and Rondo Segura were here, and they played 10 minutes a night because you had Perkins and Harris and Massenburg.
Learn, you know.
Yeah, learn. And I would think that as frustrated as those guys might have been for, I would look back on that and say that's the best thing that ever happened.
Oh, 100%. Because most of the time, these guys are the absolute best players that their prep school or high school have to offer. So it's tough coming to college and saying, hey, wait a second, I might not be the best player, you know. Everyone thinks they should be playing Jamon Bivens.
Jamon Bivens off the bench hitting the bucket for the Bulls. And Ty Perry going to get called for that foul. It's where this program has gotten to and where it's managed properly by Jim Weitzel, in that you can bring a bunch of kids in and let them learn, play them a little bit, let them get better, but they'll get better mostly by practicing against your plethora of all MAC performers. You know, again, no better example of that, as we mentioned, Jonathan and Rondo, highly touted recruits who didn't play very much, but look what they have turned into. Yep. Exactly what everyone expected them, all MAC level players and amongst the best players in the conference.
That's ideal. I mean, it's all well and good if you've got a freshman who's just so good that you can't keep it from having him on the court. But if you can at all, let them settle in and, you know, like you said, the 10, 15 minutes, learn, practice, get bigger, you know, sort of get accustomed to this level of basketball, they're going to be so much better off down the stretch. I mean, there's just case after case of proof that guys who can learn for a year or two are typically just so much better and well-seasoned come junior and senior year.
Curtis Jones drew the foul for the Bulls. Possession to the Medialle Mavericks, who will get themselves going in their scheduled non-conference in the next couple of weeks. Picked to finish fifth in the preseason AMCC poll, the Allegheny Mountain Collegiate Conference, if you were wondering. And as we said, they're just happy to be playing. They barely played last year, officially only 2 games, so this got to feel good just to have regular practices and regular games to get to show themselves off here.
These kids are playing because they love basketball.
Sure.
And that's exactly what they're getting to do. Sure. Not most of these kids are coming to Medialle and saying, I'm going to go play pro maybe after. So these kids are playing just because they love the game, which is awesome.
Perry drives the baseline. Too hard off the glass. It rolls around, and then I thought he fouled on the attempt, but no. He was able to kind of force a mistake by Medialle, and it'll be out of bounds to the Bulls.
Yeah, it looked like maybe last touch by Ryan Mers, the 6-foot freshman from Lancaster. Let's see. Yep. He kind of came in from out of bounds.
This is Bivens. And Matting has come back into the ball game. Big number 0. Perry kind of pinballing off people down the lane. He says, how did he come to call foul for that? But Ty able to get it in for the hoop. He must have collided with 3 different players.
Yeah, and the ref's probably saying, well, I'm not calling a foul because it's a 40-point game with 8 minutes left.
Yeah, that might be it.
I don't need to blow the whistle every possession.
Turnover there by Zion Tyson, freshman guard for Medialle. Good crowd here on hand as you're getting a look at.
Definitely.
People just excited to be back in here at Alumni. A great turnout by the students. You mentioned that in the first half, worth mentioning again.
Especially, you know, with everything going on in the world, that we're telling people you have to have a vaccination card and you've got to wear a mask to come, and it's got to be on to watch it. And there's still all these people in here. It's just a testament to how much people in Western New York love their Bulls.
Look at the long arms by Matting to get that rebound off the blocker miss.
Yeah, give me more Matting. I love this.
6'9", 202 from High Point, North Carolina. Played high school at the Burlington School, All-State when he played there. And as you said, he's 6'9", 200.
McDonald's All-American nominee. Come on now.
You bet.
New brisket at Chipotle. Seasoned, smoked, seared, spiced, sauced, bold, and guaced. It's a whole new kind of brisket done the Chipotle way.
Whoa. Every week, millions of fantasy football players need to be confident they're making the right decision.
What's up with CeeDee Lamb?
How does ESPN help them make smarter trades and set the right lineup?
Does this look bad?
I don't know. I'm not that kind of doctor.
IBM Watson. By analyzing everything from player stats to expert opinions, Watson cuts through the noise to deliver game-changing insights.
Boomer Bust says CeeDee Lamb is going
to
boom.
To keep ESPN at the top of the fantasy sports world.
He's good.
What can Watson do for your business?
Well, it's been a fun night here at Alumni Arena. Maybe not so much for the Medialle Mavericks, though, Matt. But they're playing. I think that's all they cared about.
Six games in 2020-2021. So, you know, COVID affected a lot of teams, a lot of different squads. But, you know, we were so focused about Division One that we weren't, you know, paying attention to what was going on in Division Two and Division Three here for Medialle. That stinks, really, at the end of the day. It's as flat out as that. These kids are going to college. They're there to learn and play basketball. And when you take away basketball, that stinks. So, you know, it feels good to see Medialle out here playing. They've got a good schedule ahead of them. They've got a great coach. I loved talking to him. Seems like a really bright guy. Had a great playing career. I think Medialle should be pretty excited about what's coming up this year.
Nice block right there by Cottrell Blocker. Jones will kick it out to Blocker. Into the corner for Perry. Drives the lane and hits. And, of course, it's different at Division III. It was last year. You don't have the fan attendance that generates revenue, the TV money that generates revenue. It was a lot harder for the Division III schools to play because there had to be more testing in order to do that. So most of the Division III schools just didn't play very much last year for all of those reasons. So, you know, it probably affected these kids a lot more than it did the ones here at Buffalo who did get to play somewhat of a season. That's blocked out of bounds by Matting.
I love it. By the way, Matting like might be my new favorite player. He's awesome. Love watching him play. But yeah, to your point that it's expensive playing A. Last year might have been more expensive than a normal year. I mean, with all the testing protocols and having to you know, worry about who's traveling and get separate rooms, and it was just a nightmare, really, logistically overall. So we're definitely not normal, I wouldn't say, but the fact that we're at least getting there, we're moving there, feels pretty darn good, and good for Medialle for being back in action here tonight. Okay, now I'm ready for more Matting. Let's go. What do we got?
Bulls with a 56-26 rebounding advantage. Two players with 10 rebounds in this game, Skogman and Bertram. You've got Fagan, who has 9. Boy, Matting with those long arms is just getting his in the way of everything in the lane.
He was listed as the 10th best player in North Carolina, 3-star recruit. And no, I'm judging it off a pretty small scale of events here tonight. Not a whole lot to go off of, but I think Buffalo might have themselves a winner here.
Nice drive by Curtis Jones. Yeah, obviously he's got to get a little bigger and a little bit stronger when he starts coming up against some of the competition he'll face in the MAC. You know, there's some big, strong gentlemen that might push him around a little bit. But again, if you're starting at 6'9 with athletic ability and long arms, that's a pretty good place to start. That's Tyler Seeley from London, England, draining the three from Medialle, one of those international players.
Everybody's getting involved for Medialle now. We've got 10 plus scores.
I was gonna say, I feel like they've had about 25 guys in this game. This is the freshman blocker. Oh, that's pretty. Okay. It just didn't go.
That was nifty.
Bivens battling for the board. So is Matting. Jump ball.
Yeah, that's... Even if that wasn't a jump ball, that's the right call to make. When you start getting some of those big bodies wrestling back and forth and the ball's bopping around, blow it dead, make sure no one gets hurt.
That's the type of play you see where two guys get tied up and then someone throws an elbow.
That's a nice tip and a steal by Bile. That'll leave a bad taste in the mouth of the Bulls. But a possession back to Buffalo. Jones, too hard off the glass. Perry with a nice rebound and a putback. And a little yell and chest pump for Ty Perry.
He's been pretty darn impressive. That's a dozen points on 4 of 5 shooting for Ty. He's been aggressive to the basket. Strong, strong young fella. Look at that.
6'3", 210. And again, played big-time college basketball in the Atlantic 10 at Fordham. So he's been around. He's been in the battles for a while. He knows what it's going to take.
Sure. He's had a season-high 18 points against LaSalle in Philadelphia. I said earlier, led the Rams in three-pointers made. I think this is another one of those under-the-radar transfers that, you know, he may not come out and average 12 or 15 a game, but even if he's scoring, you know, 6 to 8 and giving you the energy that he's brought today.
Comes in and hits a couple threes off the bench for you.
Big time, big time. That's all you need. That's literally all you need to build a championship team.
A little over 5 minutes to go in this one. Exhibition opener, and Lucas Soleil, one of the walk-ons for the Bulls, has checked into the ballgame, number 22. Former high school teammate of Jonathan Williams. Prep school teammate
California,
of Jonathan Williams,
right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Not high school in Rochester, in case you were wondering.
The West Coast boy.
That one way off by Bile.
I mean, Medialle might have been lucky there. It was about 4-on-1, all with a head of steam going the other way that they blew that dead for a shot clock violation. Sort of give the Mavericks a chance to settle in here.
So obviously this is a chance for some guys to get a an opportunity to play that may not, as the schedule goes on, depending on how the games turn out. But, you know, again, Soleil gets in off the bench, and Cottrell Blocker, who doesn't figure to play a ton this year just because of the guys that are ahead of him. Oh, that guy might play a little this year.
What was that?
How's that for your first basket in a Buffalo uniform? Cruel Manning is his name.
Goat, love him. So cool about it, too. I mean, what was that? He just acted like he was ho-hum. They must have been doing, does he do this all every day?
Watch this.
Wow.
That was elbow even with the rim air. How about that?
Okay,
here's you, look at this angle.
Hello. Look at this. He's going to grab, we're going to need the camera adjusted. Go grab Coel. Just reach up and get it. Back with the ladder.
Jim Weitzel had said he was really intrigued by Cuel Manning and what he's seen from him in the offseason and the preseason. And as Jim kept saying, he's 6'9", he's got long arms, you know, but he's been really intrigued. And now I think we're all intrigued.
I'm in.
You know, even if it's 5 or 7 minutes a night to come in and block a couple shots and create just some disturbance in the middle of the lane, I could see that kind of role coming this year for Cuel Manning.
Absolutely. Just even if, at the very least, if it's to give Josh or Brock or LaQuill or whoever a few minutes, or if there's foul trouble even, just to have a guy like that come in and say, okay, go do your thing. Go hit your head on the roof again, please.
Yeah. How about one more time as we go to break? Cuel Manning.
History says, fine jewelry for occasions. We say, forget occasions. Fine jewelry for every day, minus the traditional markups. We're Mejuri. Handcrafted like the olden days. Designed for the golden days ahead.
Millions of fantasy football players need to be confident they're making the right decisions.
What's up with CeeDee Lamb?
By analyzing everything from player stats to expert opinions, Watson cuts through the noise to deliver game-changing insights.
Boomer Bust says CeeDee Lamb is going to...
Calm down yet, or were you ordering your president of the Cuel Manning fan club
jersey
cards?
Jersey's on the way. It's already shipping in. I'm all in. I've seen everything I need to see. That was pretty awesome. And this is the type of reason why you like the exhibition games, because if we just started our season at Michigan, you probably don't see a Cole Manning. So that's the type of stuff that you look back at an exhibition game and you go, you know what, I'm glad that happened, because that was a moment that was pretty darn cool.
We've seen everybody on the roster here tonight for Buffalo, except for a few. Laquil Hardnett's a little banged up. He did not play today. He should be ready to go for the bulk of the season. Freshman Zakir Williamson, also a little banged up, won't play today. And you might be wondering, hey, is Dominic Johnson still in the mix here? Well, Dominic is busy as the starting wide receiver on the football team, but I did ask Jim if Dominic would have the chance to come back once the football season is over, and I get the sense in Jim's response, which is he's got a chance to maybe prepare to play professional football, and we would want him to focus on that.
Sure.
He's already been drafted by the Edmonton Elks in the Canadian Football League, so whether it's an NFL opportunity, at the very least, Dominic will have a chance to go play in the Canadian Football League. And of course, he's been a guy who's been on and off this basketball roster for years and a guy that everybody loves, but it's been fun seeing Dominic emerge as a football player.
Yeah.
Had his best game ever this past a week or so ago, this past Saturday, in the game against Bowling Green.
What a good problem to have if you're Dom Johnson. Be like, yeah, wait, I'm so good at football, I can't go play D1 basketball also.
Right.
Sorry, guys. A little busy being really good at this thing, too.
Yeah. Three-pointer is short there by Madai, but they'll get it back to Zach Fulford. And he'll try it again, and things aren't going so great there.
He just blocked that from 7 feet out.
Blocker, Eurostep. Cottrell's got a lot of hustle. We got to get him to figure out how to finish, because he's fun to watch when he's getting to the rim.
Yeah, he's super athletic too. Really quick. A little taller than Rondo, but sort of reminds me so far of the build and how quick he is of a young Sagu.
Played at Tennessee Prep after leaving Rochester. You're our designated Rochester expert.
Sure.
Cottrell blocker. Trying to figure out what high school Cottrell played at while he was in Rochester. Well, a little bit at Aquinas and a little bit of Bishop Kearney.
Can't have that. Bishop Kearney I'm okay with. I'm a McQuay Jesuit graduate.
Boy, here we
anybody
go.
From see? Rochester.
See, I opened up the can of worms
aware.
On that one.
Big time rivals. Don't like the Aquinas. I'm okay with the Bishop Kearney, though.
All right.
No,
well,
I'm
we're okay with Cottrell blocker, so no matter where he went to school.
Agreed.
A little over 2 minutes to go in this one. Bulls over 100 points. A little shy of a 50-point lead, but that's all to be expected when a team like Buffalo takes on a Division III opponent. Another Euro step, and Cottrell just flinging it up there, and thankfully Jamon Bivens there to clean it up.
How about Jamon Bivens is just like quietly got 6 points all of a sudden. He's just cleaning things up around the rim. Love seeing that. Good effort.
I feel like we need one more Kuel Manning moment here before we're done tonight.
Oh, here we go. Come on.
Lucas Soleil, blocker.
Oh!
That moment.
We'll take that. Must be nice to just be able to run down the court and do that. Make it look easy. I think you and I could stand on each other's shoulders maybe and touch the
I
rim.
I need a 10-foot
oh,
ladder.
Here we go. Clear
Here's Kuel Manning.
Oh, no!
He missed it.
He missed. He was too busy trying to put his head through the rim.
Oh, Kuel had his moment, chance right there, and it just didn't happen. There will be other chances.
The whole bench is still upset that that didn't go down. And maybe a little bit of friendly...
They must have seen it a little in practice to know what potentially was coming. So the technical foul goes on Matting for hanging on the rim. Jeff Cook, the Amherst native freshman, hit the free throw for Madai. All right, we got a minute 17 left. We have one more, and at least another chance at another Kuel Manning moment here. See him finish one of those off. Did you see the Medialle player try to quickly throw the ball back into his teammate?
Yes.
Maybe they wouldn't notice that he's on the bench
quick,
when that happened.
Cool. Act cool. No one saw it. Just get it back in, guys.
That was impressive. Very impressive. I don't know which player it was for Medialle, but that's
funny.
My favorite moment of the night.
Lucas.
They might as well just let Medialle throw six or seven guys out on the court here. Why not for the last minute? Jones with the spin. Bivens throws it away.
Good deep. Good hustle.
Final 30 seconds in this one. Look how high they got to throw it in there to get it up and over Kuel Mating.
How fun. Loved it.
And that will bring this one to an end. A 105-54 exhibition season opening victory for the Buffalo Bulls. Get those winning feelings started right now for the Mid-American Conference favorites. We'll take a break. We'll come back with our postgame show. Get that man, Jim Weitzel's thoughts on what happened here tonight. Matt and I return in just a moment on ESPN3.
New brisket at Chipotle. Seasoned. Smoked. Seared, spiced, sauced, bold, and guaced. It's a whole new kind of brisket done the Chipotle way.
Whoa.
Every week, millions of fantasy football players need to be confident they're making the right decision.
What's up with CeeDee Lamb?
How does ESPN help them make smarter trades and set the right lineup?
Does this look bad?
I don't know. I'm not that kind of doctor.
IBM Watson. By analyzing everything from player stats to expert opinions, Watson cuts through the noise to deliver game-changing insights.
Boomer Bust says CeeDee Lamb is going
to
boom.
To keep ESPN at the top of the fantasy sports world.
He's good.
What can Watson do for your business?
Buffalo following the Bulls 105-54 exhibition opening victory over the Medialle Mavericks. Paul Peck with Matt Mattia, now joined by Buffalo head coach Jim White. So go ahead, peruse those stats first, Jim, so you can tell us exactly what you liked the most out of this, or maybe what you didn't like out of this one.
Well, I think give Medialle a lot of credit. I mean, obviously this thing came up with the Damon situation of COVID, so really appreciate those guys filling in, because we really needed to play in front of our fans and just get our feet wet a little bit. I thought we had some good stretch the first half. Jadavis got the ball moving a little bit. We started getting some kick-aheads. We shot the free throw pretty good the last 10 minutes. Plenty to work on, believe you me. Plenty to work on, but it's good to get these guys their feet wet. And it's great just to be back here and play in front of our fans.
All right, quick talk to me about what's up next, right? This is the game. You got your legs under yourselves. You saw another jersey. Couple of days off. Out to Ann Arbor to play the sixth-ranked Wolverines.
Yeah, we got to have a great hard practice tomorrow. We'll be off Saturday and get ready for them. Obviously, they're outstanding. They're, you know, three in the country. You know, we got our hands full. But, I think our guys will look at the tape a little bit tomorrow, and we'll get ready for them and make some progress. I think we did some good things passing the ball. We moved it better. We'll keep building some of our depth with some of our young kids. You got to make progress, and you got to have a good practice tomorrow. Let's just take it day by day and get better.
You know what you have in your stars, and we saw that on display with Mbala and Thrando Segou and Jonathan Williams. But this was probably you were most looking forward to seeing some of your new guys, and maybe it was Amacio Jack and how he fits into this game, or maybe it was the guys that you hadn't seen much of at all before. And I know I can speak for Matt by saying he's already president of the Kuel Mattin.
Buy me a jersey, like,
right
stat. I need a jersey quick.
Yeah, Kuel's got a chance to be a special player. He's just got to continue to work hard and keep making progress, but I love his length there. You know, I thought Keyshawn Bruton, I thought Maceo came in, gave his good energy. Dave Scobin kind of, he had those three fouls, but then he calmed down and started playing like he can. We're going to need him to come around. I thought Ty Perry came in and gave us some good minutes. Kurt got good solid minutes there. Cottrell Blocker, I thought, showed some really good potential out there. So we just got to keep working at it. It's early in the season, much as expected, but along with it, you got to take it day by day and just get a little bit better and get stronger and tougher. So
Much ahead of us.
All right. Much ahead of you, including that big one coming up against Michigan. Jim, appreciate the time. Always good to catch up. And congratulations on a good start to the season based on
Thanks,
what it was today.
Appreciate
so, Jim Weitzel, UB Bulls head coach. We're not done yet because we're going to get a chance to talk to Janaith Williams here and get his take on what he saw there. I hope that you see Victory Bowl photobomb and Jim Weitzel
trying
there.
To get
so
in there. You know, whatever.
Know,
trying to get a little those, it's not like he doesn't get enough camera time running around the gym. Right?
Janaith, grab that microphone and tell us a little bit about what you wanted to accomplish here tonight, not just you personally, but for this team as a whole, and do you feel like you got that done?
Yes, I mean, we just came to, you know, get the game jitterbugs out and just, you know, have a fun time and just lock in. You know, we play a big game with Michigan next week, and so this is like preparation for us, like another practice to just get right and have fun and get the jitterbugs out.
You and Josh and Rondo, obviously very comfortable with each other, good friends, you know, play a ton of basketball together, but
right.
First time with a lot of these new faces. I mean, we talked about it a little bit, Maceo and Ty, just to name a few, transferring in some of the young guys. For you now, being the elder statesman, I know it probably went quick, and you're all of a sudden you're looking at and you're like, oh God, I'm a senior. You know, what's that like that you're now sort of taking some of these younger guys under their wing and just kind of gelling with some of the new faces?
It's good. I mean, just showing them the ropes and showing them how to do things the right way. You know, showing them hard work and teaching them little things about the offense and the defense. And just being a leader. You know, just being there for the guys every single day and getting better in practice every single day.
What are your expectations for this season, Janathan? Not just for yourself, but for this team, and maybe we saw some glimpses of how good and how dangerous you guys can be here tonight, but how are you approaching this season?
Just to win games, you know, just to win games and be great, you know. I just want us to, you know, play good basketball and everybody eat on the court, and, I mean, things to take care of itself.
All right. Hey, good luck. Congratulations on getting the season off to a good start. Good luck moving forward to the non-conference schedule. That's Janaith Williams, and he figures to be a pretty steady guest here for us on the post-game show because he's going to be a really steady, good player for the Bulls this year. We all know what this is, Matt. We knew what the challenge was or Division III team coming in here, but as you thought about what you wanted to see when you walked in here today, summarize now that we've seen what we saw.
Definitely. Got to see what we needed to, right? You saw that Josh is as better as ever. He's just looking fantastic. Janathan and Rondo are still gelling as an inside-outside combo. That's great. You got to see some new faces. You and I talked about that. That's always the best part of an exhibition is getting to see some of the new guys, some of the transfers. And really, I mean, there's not much to complain about. 105 points. They looked solid. They looked like this wasn't the first time they were playing this season. So really pretty thrilled with what we saw. And honestly, just pretty psyched for Wednesday to take on Michigan.
Yeah, and based on tonight, more reasons to be excited about the team that is picked to win the Mid-American Conference and should have one of those amazing, memorable, dynamic seasons. It's off to a start. A good one here tonight. An exhibition opener for the Bulls. We thank you for joining us for both the women's game earlier, the men's game tonight. For our entire crew of Matt Mattia, my name is Paul Peck. Thanks for watching. This has been a production of ESPN and the Mid-American Conference.